Hi everyone, I'm Dave Pardue here in the Deep South, and I'm trekking around with the new Tamron 70 to 180 millimeter f2.8 for Sony FE mount. When you pair it with the A7R Mark IV, you get a lot of zoom firepower combined with a lot of resolution, and yet you're still only packing just over 3 pounds of weight, or less than 1,500 grams. Is trimming 20 millimeters off the focal length worth it? Is this lens for you? Let's find out. First, we'll head down to the Rock Lab to meet the cast. The Tamron 70 to 180 millimeter f2.8 is the third iteration of Tamron's affordable and lightweight line of f2.8 lenses, following the 17 to 28 and 28 to 75 millimeter f2.8 DI3 models. As you can likely tell, Tamron doesn't have an issue with choosing non-standard focal lengths for their zooms, and I find it refreshing. Of course, the Sony A7R Mark IV is just a phenomenal workhorse of a camera. I wanted the highest resolution model they offered in order to see just how sharp the images from the lens could get. The 70 to 200 millimeter f2.8 G Master has also been a solid workhorse for many years and is the de facto standard for this classic focal length range in the FE mount world. And we'll use it to compare sharpness across the focal length range in just a bit. And then we'll also include a Sony A6400 so that we can see how the 70 to 180 millimeter images look with the 1.5 times crop factor that you get from shooting a full frame lens on an APS-C body. Tamron tells us the lens is compact and lightweight, and that much you can tell as soon as you pull it out of the box. It feels solid and stable, yet refreshingly light. And they also state the lens is moisture resistant on their official product page. But I honestly don't know what that means, so I reached out to Tamron for guidance on this. They've assured me that light drizzle and light snow are not an issue with this lens, and you can see in this image they provided us that clearly shows at least 9 gaskets used at critical seal points. Tamron tells us the lens has fast, quiet focusing, and I can already tell you from my initial runs in the field that it's quite fast and quiet. We'll take a more in-depth look at this in just a bit. And they also state that the lens works with Sony's advanced autofocus performance features, such as fast hybrid AF and IAF, and I'll be taking a look at this in the field as well. The lens sports a minimum object distance of 33.5 inches across the entire zoom range, but it also has a clever close focusing ability at 70 millimeters that allows you to focus manually as close as 10.6 inches. The two primary ways this lens is obviously lacking compared to a lens like the 70 to 200 millimeter f2.8 G Master are mainly just two. It doesn't go the distance of 200 millimeters like classic 70 to 200 sports lenses, and there's no image stabilization, which is primarily only a factor if your camera body doesn't provide it. Okay, so let's head out into the field and see what this lightweight lens is actually capable of. Let's start with the hardest part and cut right to the chase. The A7R Mark IV is lightning fast and offers terrific tracking algorithms. Tamron claims the lens is capable of utilizing these and keeping up, and I wanted to find out right away. In my experience reviewing cameras and lenses for you for 8 years now, I've found that with moving subjects, a keeper ratio of anything higher than about 70 to 80% is quite acceptable, especially with any high contrast subjects looming in the background. The 70 to 180 millimeter f2.8 didn't hardly miss a beat in all my rounds of bursts, including birds in flight, racing kids, dirt bikes, and jumping dogs. I got a roughly 95% keeper rate overall, with only a single miss out of 10 on every third burst or so, which could easily be attributed to simple user error. I employed both regular continuous AF and also tracking and IAF, and it passed all of these tests with high marks for keeper rates. And there's not a trace of any AF sound at all. So for wildlife purposes and shooting in quiet environments, you can be assured of ultra quiet performance. The ability to capture critically sharp images to send to a full frame sensor with 61 megapixels is an important criteria for a high-end lens. For our purposes today, we're going to compare the sharpness at and near the center of the frame at both the widest angle of 70 millimeters and the telephoto end of 180 millimeters, putting them side by side against the Sony G Master. We'll shoot wide open at f2.8, and also at f8 as well to see the results stop down. To my eye, both lenses produce crisp images at both ends of the focal range and at both aperture settings. And here we see a comparison zoomed all the way to 100% for a super detailed look as well. I can't find any discernible evidence of one being sharper than the other here in the heart of the frame. They're both quite crisp overall. We'll also be putting the lens up on our test rack so that we can show you sharpness comparisons in the corners. But for now, at least we know the lens is critically sharp in and near the center of the frame. The minimum object distance for the 70-180mm is 33.5 inches across the focal length range, which gives you a closest magnification of 1 to 4.6. However, when you lock the lens at 70mm and engage manual focus, you can approach your subject to within 10.6 inches and get right into the heart of the matter. This isn't technically true macro photography, as Tamron is clear to point out that the periphery focus won't likely be critically sharp. But the feature sure can yield some nice images, and it's a fun bonus to have for intriguing close-ups. On to one of my favorite aspects of photography. Much like fine wine, elegant clothes, and even music, people's tastes range wildly in regards to what they consider good bokeh from a photographic lens. Even the definition of bokeh is widely debated, but for the sake of this report, I'm going to simply call it the out-of-focus areas both in front of and behind the primary subject. As a reviewer, I have from time to time found examples of bokeh that I didn't particularly like, especially at certain problem focal lengths from budget long zooms I've shot in the past. With this lens, however, I only found pleasing bokeh. There's an affordable way to get more reach from this lens, and that's to simply pair it with one of Sony's many popular crop-sensored cameras to take advantage of the 1.5 times crop factor. I've shot it here on the A6400 to give you examples of being able to reach out to an equivalent focal length of 270 millimeters at the telephoto end. This camera doesn't have image stabilization, but some of Sony's current APS-C bodies do, such as the A6500 and the A6600. But for the myriad of you out there who own one of the other models, this sampling will show you what's still possible to achieve without IS. At 180 millimeters, we're not technically into true wildlife territory, but you can certainly still capture wildlife with this lens, especially the varieties that will allow you to get close enough. I would have liked to have more reach for the hawk overhead, but that'd be a shot suited for a longer lens than even 200 millimeters anyway. The virtually silent focusing mechanism certainly comes to our aid here, and assuming you have all your camera sounds turned off, you can operate very quietly in close quarters. All in all, I found this lens quite capable for close wildlife shooting. One amazing thing about the focal length range from this lens is that it basically covers all of the most classic portrait focal lengths. Obviously, a 70 to 200 millimeter does as well, and yet 70 to 180 almost sounds more like it was made for this purpose. So this is one area where having less reach doesn't matter, and less weight very much comes in handy. This lens excels in many ways, but to me it shines the brightest as a versatile, all-around portrait lens. Okay, so let's say you're training for a prize fight, and your manager tells you that you have to train carrying your sport zoom with you. Do you really want to be hauling around a big boat anchor? Me neither. The most powerful evolutionary front in camera and lens design is the move towards making the gear smaller and lighter, and lower in cost, while still maintaining good image quality and features. The Tamron 70-180mm f2.8 has achieved this in a clever way by trading off just a few features and then delivering the most important ones, along with terrific image quality in a smaller, lighter package. It is well built, it's well designed, and can deliver wonderful images across its entire focal range. Thanks for watching, everybody.